right, you all, I am going to be doing Blue Jeans today by Lana Del Rey. I know this song. I know the words of the song. I've sang the song a million times, many, many years ago. Never saw the music video. After reacting to the music video, Born to Die, I am so excited to watch this music video. So many of you asked me to react to it. As much as I have shown my love for Lana, I have been snoozing on how influential her music videos are, how layered they are, how impactful they are, the stance that they take. For any of you that are new to my channel, please subscribe. Also, if you don't know much about me, I wrote a book recently that was published called Hey Addiction, Thanks for Nothing, a brutally honest guide to loving an addict without losing your mind. This book is for anyone who's loved someone with a drug or alcohol addiction and not known what to do about it and basically have lost themselves trying to help someone else. This book is for you. Please read it. Also, if you want to be a member, join. I've rambled enough. Let's do this. This is really interesting. I mean, I really like the sparkles around her. She doesn't necessarily look happy. I can already see that she has white on and the ripples of the water. If I ever got the chance to interview Lana, I would love to talk to her about water. I was just talking about this with a friend of mine today whose street is completely flooded. I just was writing her like, we have to respect water. And she's like,
what?
Like, I love water so much. And I feel like Lana does too. And I would love to discuss our love of water together.
I'm a weirdo.
Okay, let's do it again. Oh, this buddy in the last music video was holding her dead because he was reckless, didn't respect her and her body. And I think, like one of my subscribers mentioned, that he killed her, didn't feel that bad about it. It was no real cost to him. He was probably like, well, she wanted it because she was being adventure. Oh my God, he wanted it. Oh, that makes me think of like, sorry, that just took me back to a session with a client so many years ago that had dealt with a sexual assault and confronting the person later on, never going to police. And she said, he said, you know, you basically asked for it. When I think about the Born to Die video, she was, you know, you like your girls insane and being like wild. I feel like that was partly for him. It makes me think of Harvey Weinstein. It kind of reminds me of that like gross narrative, the victim blaming where, well, she was wearing a short dress. She was asking for it or she wanted it, you know? Okay. See, this is the thing about Lana. This is why I've told you all before in the past, I stopped listening to her for a really long time because she evokes so much and it's not a negative thing. It's showing how powerful her art is that just seeing an image of that man again now in this video and remembering the way that he held her and then the comment from the subscriber about how he can carry on with his life, that he essentially killed her and didn't seem remorseful because it was kind of like, well, she was asking for it. And like it made me think of she's asking for it, then tied into that. I mean, it's like, this is where it takes me. It takes me to a really deep place. This is in black and white. I feel like it's gonna be dark. I do. And I'm trying to think of Blue Jeans, what this song is about, and I don't even remember. I just know the words. All right, let me reverse a little bit. I'm sorry, you all.
Fresh to death and sick as cancer. You were sort of punk rock. I grew up on hip hop. You fit me better than my favorite sweater. And
Okay. I don't know. Clearly I have things to work through, but these type of scenes make me a little uncomfortable, make me want to laugh. I think it's a coping mechanism. So anyways, I actually kind of like this. It seems as if Lana's the one watching him and he doesn't know it. So it's a little voyeuristic. And I kind of like it that she's looking at the man. It's like reversing the role, you know, where men can sometimes be like complete alleged creeps. I mean, there's a reason why peeping Toms are Toms, you know? Okay. Also, I know I'm using a lot of gendered language just because I am acknowledging what I'm seeing on the screen. Okay. All right. Here we go. I just want to say, get your fingers out of her mouth, please. Get your gross fingers. You know, he's probably smoked a cigarette and didn't wash his hands, and then he stuck his fingers in her mouth, and that really bothers me.
I'm sorry, you guys.
I know that that's like alluding to a sexual thing, but I also don't like it because of in Born to Die video, he did like the finger, two fingers together like that to her head, and then now he's going like in her mouth, and I'm sorry, it alludes to murder to me, or disrespect. It alludes to also different ways that people take their lives or harm someone else by shooting them, typically in the head and the mouth, things like that. I don't like it. Well, let me talk about the lyrics a little bit. She said, so fresh to death and sick as cancer. So it sounds like he's a person that looks really good, but he is sick. Like, he's a cancer. I don't think the astrological sign, I think that he is actually, like, she knows it isn't something she should probably touch. And the fact that he made her eyes burn, I feel like sometimes our body gives us signals, and that's not necessarily a good thing. It might burn your eyes because she knows he's bad. A lot of times women can like the bad boys. I'm definitely recovered bad boy lover. And she's already calling out their differences because she's like acknowledging that he grew up on punk rock and she grew up on hip hop. So it's like they aren't of the same, but a lot of times we're attracted to, we don't know, like something different. It's exciting. She's also talking about how love is mean and love hurts. So yeah, he hurts her. He shoves his fingers down her mouth. I get so angry, you all. Some of this is my stuff, okay? Some of it's my stuff. Saying here, like, I've loved you the best. It sounds as if she just adored him. Like she loved him more than anybody could love him. She saw all of the beautiful colors of him. And I have the feeling or the impression that like he didn't recognize her greatness. I also see the difference between the fact that he has black boxers on and she has a white bathing suit on. Gangsta said you had to leave to start your life over. I was like, no, please stay here. We don't need no money, we can make it all work. But he headed out on Sunday, said he'd come on Monday. I said I'm waiting, anticipate. Sorry, there's something creepy about it being eye level and that he's just peering over and looking at her, and she's not like jumping and frolicking in, and she doesn't look happy to get in the pool with him. There's hesitation there, and he kind of moves a little animalistic, I feel. Predatory. This could just be like complete projection on my part that he looks animalistic or predatory, but anyways, she seems hesitant. She seems afraid to get in with him. Need no money, we can make it all work. But he headed out on Sunday, said he'd come on Monday. I said I'm waiting, anticipating and pacing, but he was chasing. Oh my god, is that an alligator or a crocodile or something? What is this? Man. Okay, let me think about the lyrics for a second. So it seems like she was loving him unconditionally because she was saying, like, we don't need money, we can make it work. It seems like he just like up and left. He felt like he needed to do his thing. He just discarded her. Jerk.
Life over, I was like, no, please stay here. We don't need no money, we can make it all work. But he headed out on Sunday, said he'd come on Monday. I stayed up waiting, anticipating and pacing, but he was chasing.
He's evil. He's evil. He is an alligator in the water coming to get her. I feel like I was right about predatory. Like, she didn't know what she was messing with. Especially, you know, his interest was money. Money, greed. She's saying, love is enough. Like, I'm gonna love you whether you have money or not. But he was selfish and went and did whatever he wanted. And she was basically discarded. Like, if she's saying that's the last I heard, and I don't know, her, she's gonna go into, I will love you till the end of time. I'm like, no, don't. He's not good. He's not worthy.
Promise you'll remember that you're mine. Baby, can you see through the tears? Love you more and those bitches before. Say you'll remember.
Essentially killed her again. I thought there for a while she was dead, like she had drowned, and then she opened her eyes, but then he pulled her back down again. I want to warn you all, like, you don't put up with anything, okay? Never tell someone, like, you could do anything and I would stay by your side, because she says that. She says, you went out every night, and baby, that's all right. No matter what you did, I would be right by your side. I'm gonna be your ride or die. What did he do to earn that? That's what I wanna know. Can't do whatever they want every night and you stay with them. I think that this is a very powerful message that she's sending, that she's saying these words, and these are all of the things that she did that ultimately led to her dying, getting drowned and taken down by someone else and their choices and lack of care for her precious life. I do feel like when she said they took you away, stole you out of my life, I mean, that's how I feel about my ex-husband with drugs and alcohol. I do feel like they took him away and took him out of my life. One of the things that I did was stay and be the ride or die for way too long, till it was almost the death of me. I feel like this song is such a warning. But now I'm thinking about ultra violence, and I wish when you all urged me to listen to this in order, that would have been so amazing, because now I'm looking at it and I'm like, oh my gosh, I feel like I would look at ultra violence different now. But I feel like she's been such a teacher. Like, if you really, really watch the videos. It's a warning. If you give everything to someone, if you put them on a pedestal and think that they're the best thing ever and that you're gonna love them forever and they can do anything to you and you still will be there, it's gonna kill you, okay? I might not just mean physically kill you. I can mean like people can continue walking on this earth in their bodies, but their soul is gone because someone has demolished it. So any of you out there that feel as if you're in a toxic relationship or feel as if the person is taking advantage of you or isn't really understanding your worth and treating you the way that you should be treated, then walk away. All right, this thing gets me really revved up, really upset. It just like makes me really sad and emotional just to see her going down in the water that way. And then after just seeing her die and born to die, it's too much. Okay, I'm gonna go now. I love you all. Let me know what you wanna see next, okay? You all take care.